something I noticed about you guys is you really enjoy when I humiliate myself for you in a video.
He said he want him a reekin, a foreign thing, no English speaking. No hablo inglés at all when we freaking. It's always intriguing, cause I gotta do all the teaching.
The other night I was having a conversation about this weird thing I used to do when I was a little girl, and it got me thinking that I should do a video like weird stuff I used to do / think as a little girl. I was a weird kid. Still kind of weird. The story that started this whole idea was the time when I truly believed that I could breathe underwater. I'm not kidding. I don't know how old I was in any of these stories, but I'm just gonna guess how old I could have maybe been. In this story, I want to say I was 7, maybe 8. I was old enough to be wearing like a little bikini, but young enough to be like really fucking stupid. During the summers, sometimes we would go to the pool club for the day. I had about like 3 or 4 girlfriends that would hang with me at the pool, and we would get really, really fucking bored. So we'd make little games up, and one of the games that we would play was to see who could hold their breaths the longest underwater. You know those ladders that go into the pool, you know, like there's like... What we would do is go to the deep end and swim to the bottom and then hold on to the ladder that was in the water so like we couldn't float up, and then just stay there as long as we possibly could. And whoever stayed down there the longest won because they could hold their breath the longest. Another embarrassing thing about me is when I go underwater, I had to hold my nose, like, I would hold my nose, I would go down, hold onto the ladder, and I don't even know how to explain this. Like, because I had my nose plugged, when I would swallow, like, it would bring air.
That makes no sense.
I don't know. But I'm not even lying when I say that I could stay down there longer than anyone. But this is where the stupidity comes in. I, for some reason, got this idea in my head that because I was able to do this, that maybe I can breathe underwater. I convinced myself that I was a mermaid or something. Or maybe like I was a fish in my past life and like I just had this ability to breathe underwater. I kid you guys not, I took it upon myself one day to test this out. I went to the pool. I made it a point to tell my mom that like we have to go there really, really early because I didn't want a bunch of people around while I did this because then they would know my secret. So we went to the pool before anyone got there, and I went to the deep end. I went underwater and I literally just breathed.
You are so dumb. I am embarrassed you are my mother.
Like, I just breathed. I breathed in all of the water, thinking that I was fucking Ariel over here and I could just breathe underwater and like it wouldn't kill me. I swear to God, I don't know how I'm still alive sometimes. The amount of dumb stuff I've done is just insane. But yeah, your girl took a big breath underwater and very quickly realized that I was not a mermaid. So I had to swim up really quickly because I was like dying. I remember just like flopping onto the pavement. I was choking, I was red, I was like about to throw up. It was not a good time. Do not do this at home. Next story. This one is embarrassing, very embarrassing. But this is how I thought that sex happened. Again, I don't know how old I was, but I'm just gonna guess maybe 4th grade, 3rd grade. I was young and I was getting ready for school. I was like in the kitchen getting my lunch together and the radio was on. I don't remember exactly what was said. Something along the lines of like his... This is also not YouTube friendly. Whatever. They were talking about sex. I'm not really sure what the conversation was, but something about like a dick going to a
female genitalia.
Something that they said made me think that this is how sex worked. Two people would lay down in bed and the dick would just like magically, like the guy would just be laying down. He wouldn't be doing anything. He wouldn't be moving. And the dick would magically walk itself over into the...
Stop being a pussy, mother. We all know you have a dirty mouth off camera.
And like, that's how it happened. It wasn't putting anything in manually. It would just do it by itself. I don't know how to say this without using the words, but the dick would like go and like the opening of it would, like, you know, the girls,
For Christ's sake, I will just do everything clitoris.
Would go into the tip of the dick, and like that's how sex would happen. So after I heard that on the radio, I always thought that's how sex happens until I realized it's not how it happens. Thank God. I mean, that would be weird. The next story is I was oddly attracted to like vampires. So at some point in my childhood, I saw the movie The Little Vampire, and I had such a crush on like the little vampire dude. I can't explain it. I just really liked him. At the very end of the movie, the little vampire dude, I guess that's what we're calling him now, becomes a human again. And I remember being so disappointed when he became like a human and he wasn't wearing like the cape and he didn't have the fangs. He was like normal. I was like, no. I like you better when you look dead. So yeah, I think that's where it started. And when I say I was attracted to vampires, like I didn't want anyone to suck on my blood or anything. I don't really even know how to explain it. I did try to go on the internet and find a vampire, which as a little girl is dangerous. I went on many websites and was trying to figure out how to like summon a vampire. Or I'd try to find real vampires online. Like I would go into chats and I'd be like, hey, is anyone with a vampire here? And I actually had one guy tell me that he was, but I think he was like in his 40s. So the last story is the time when I tried to seduce my fourth grade teacher.
All of these are just very sexual. I didn't really realize that.
I had the biggest crush on my fourth grade teacher. Like it was really, really bad. He wasn't like super old. He was probably in his late 20s, but still, you know, as a fourth grader, where did I think this was gonna go? We had a piano in the classroom for some reason. We would always play The Piano Man by Billy Joel. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight. When we're all in the mood for... And we'd all sing along to it. Like, it was a dope-ass time. I did not care that we had an age difference. I did not care that it was illegal. I wanted this man. So on this particular day of this story, it's Halloween. And as you guys know, if you went to school, you all dress up for Halloween. You wouldn't go to school in your outfit, but you would change into your outfit sometime during the day. And then they'd have like the kids march around outside and all the parents would come, like it was a thing. And then they would let us out early because we'd all go trick-or-treating. Like it was, I miss those days. So for Halloween, I decided that this was my chance to seduce this teacher because I was gonna wear the sexiest little devil outfit and he was gonna be my boyfriend and like, such a love story. So the outfit that me and my mom put together was not the outfit that I was gonna be wearing in front of my teacher. I did some alterations. It was basically like a bodysuit, like a red bodysuit with fishnet stockings. I obviously had the horns and like the tail. I think I had some red heels on and just like a cape that covered my entire body. And again, my mom did not know. Like there was more to this costume when we put it together, but I slutted it up basically. Because I was like, I need this man to take me seriously. Like I want to be his girlfriend. So I have to show him.
This is so fucked up.
I'll just never forget when I... When I walked back into the classroom, I made sure to make a scene about it because like I wanted this to be my moment. I think I like slammed the door so he would turn his head and see me. And I was hoping right then and there he was gonna be like, damn. I had my cape like covering me, so when he turned and looked at me, I like... I wish I was making this up. I really wish I was making this up. I opened up my cape to show him what could be his, and it didn't really go the way that I wanted to. I thought he was gonna fall madly in love with me, but instead he took me to the side and said,
I don't think you can wear that. Like, You're naked.
My heart broke so hard that day. Like, I was rejected by this man. I took all this time to try to look sexy for him, and what does he say? He tells me that I need to cover up because this isn't appropriate. My little fourth grade heart just, it broke. Some embarrassing stories from my childhood. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this, because like I said, I know a lot of you really enjoy when I embarrass myself. I probably have like a ton more, even more embarrassing stories from my childhood. I kind of threw this video together last minute, so subscribe. I love you guys so much, and I hope you're having an amazing, amazing day. Don't be me.
Bitches on my mind, but they following where we go. Kidding all these lames like Shino. Numa, do you get this game? I'm a ruler. Ancient throne, carve my name in stone. Music with a message is all I've ever known. I'm in forever gold on that forever road. And none of y'all can say that I never rose. Above and beyond my peers. It's been known I'm ahead my years. It's been known I drank too many beers. In pursuit of all of my fears. So what? So what?